Did you know that the Python programming language was named after the BBC television show Monty Python's Flying Circus? Python creator Guido von Rossum enjoyed the show so much when he was creating the language in the late 1980s, he named his creation after it. This is why when using the metasyntactic variables instead of foo and bar, you'd use spam and eggs instead. This week in Azure, Durable Functions now supports Python in preview. ARM templates got some much needed simplifications, and you can now deploy Azure Container Instances from Docker Desktop. This is Azure This Week, a show for where you come for the spam, eggs, bacon, and spam, but end up with spam, 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 baked beans, and spam.
Spam, 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 lovely spam, wonderful spam.
That's all you're getting out of me for that one.
Durable Functions are an extremely useful Azure Functions extension as it gives you the ability to define your workflows in code. Using Durable Functions, you can much more easily build things like state management, retries, and running processes in parallel in your Azure Functions. Microsoft is hoping to snake your day by adding Python to the list of languages you can now use with Durable Functions, which is another step forward in its plans to eventually support all Azure Function languages. Python has been a sorely missed language, as its uses in things like data science and analytics could really take advantage of parallel workflows, not to mention being one of the world's most utilized programming languages. While this release is still in preview, it won't be long until it's ready to slither its way into your code toolbox. ARM templates have been an important part of Azure to help automate environment buildouts and Azure tenancies. The issue is that while ARM templates make life easier, the JSON can be intimidating. So many still opt to simply use the Azure CLI or even PowerShell to deploy resources and make changes to their environment. Microsoft seems to be hoping to win more users over to using ARM templates by simplifying their configuration and adding in more tools to help users construct templates. Now, the Azure Resource Manager tool in Visual Studio Code will support code snippets, IntelliSense, in addition to some other great features like the ability to write comments and outlines. Additionally, you can now run what-if scenarios to see the predicted impact of your templates before they run. It's like having a magic 8-ball that you can ask questions about your environment. Only, you know, the chances are logically computed rather than being magical. Being able to see the predicted impact of a deployment can be extremely advantageous to ensure you're not blowing your budget, impacting critical workloads, or even if a guest host on your show will negatively impact your viewer base. Docker and containers has been synonymous for years now, so it's only natural that we see the partnership between Docker and Microsoft continue to develop with the new ability to use the Docker Desktop client to deploy and manage your Azure Container instances. Now, users who are more familiar with Docker and its CLI won't need to flip-flop back and forth between different consoles and syntax. Instead, you'll be able to manage your Azure containers and Docker containers from a single interface, freeing up valuable time and thought power for more important things, like looking up cute cat videos. Aww. Well, that's all I have for you right now, gurus. Have questions? Comments? Give us a shout in the forum for the show. You can find the link in the description. For now, just remember that when deciding the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow, seek and you shall cloud. We'll see you next week, but until then, stay awesome, gurus.
Am I a decent host for the show? Signs point to not. What do you know?